Hello and welcome back to DAVEspn. It's an away game at Sparks Stadium, the scene of the state championship last year, where Bellarmine prevailed. And here they are defending this year, warming up against Puyallup tonight. Puyallup is undefeated in league play. Bellarmine, on the other hand, is 3-3-1, suffered endured a dramatic come-from-behind tie against South Kitsap. And the final goal, the assist was by Evan Janikowski, and the goal was by Bo, new guy who wasn't on the team last year, but he sure made his presence felt to tie up that game. Bo Akiona scored that last one-touch quick goal to tie it up in the closing 20 seconds or so of the match against South Kitsap. All right, we will be ready for kickoff soon. It's Tuesday, April 18. It's about 45, maybe 48 degrees. Been raining all day, but there's no rain now. Very nice here at Sparks Stadium in Puyallup, Washington. Bellarmine will be in white. Puyallup Vikings will be in purple. Set up their medical tent without consulting anyone on the production staff here at DAVEspn, because it's kind of right in my way. But what are you gonna do? We'll catch you at kickoff.
The Washington Officials Association, the Pierce County Soccer Referees Association. The officiating crew for tonight's match is center referee Ray Moffitt Jr., assisted by Jesus Cicero Yepes and Max Mojarov. The head coaches from both teams have announced the following rosters. First, from the visiting team, Bellarmine Prep. Number 0, Ethan Fagini. Number 1, Jason Baldwin. Number 2, Tate Carlson. Number 3, Rory Moretti. Number 5, Evan Jenkinski. Number 6, Henry Marlin. Number 7, Ryan Sawyer. Number 8, Zach Kahn. Number 9, Bo Akiona. Number 10, Dane Price. Number 11, Jaggar Judkins.
Looks like Dane will not be playing tonight. Must be suffering an injury.
Number 13, Joey Pereira. Number 14, Dominic Garcia. Number 17, Anthony Daniel Yu. Number 18, Jack Marion. Number 19, Nathan Goodwin. Number 20, Hunter Martson. And number 21, Brandon Wayne. The Lions are coached by Jim Dempsey, assisted by Christian Trapp, Joey Ertzstein, Krista Kellett, and Aaron Anderson. And now, for your Puyallup Vikings.
We'll catch you at the kickoff. All right, we're just a few minutes from kickoff. The referees are checking the goals, making sure they are secured and safe, unfurling their flags. The teams are taking the field. Vikings here, this is their home field. The rain has started to pour down since I last spoke of the weather moments ago, but welcome to the Pacific Northwest. We are waiting for the Lions to break their huddle. And come out for the kickoff. Alright, looks like Jason Baldwin is going to be back in goal. He was absent against South Kitsap. Ethan Fanini did a serviceable job in the net. And Jason has changed Something about him is different. I can't put my finger on it. He looks a little brighter. I don't know what it is. Could be he's a blonde now. Looks good, Jason. Here we go. 40-minute half. 14. Dominic is at center back. And there is Mr. Baldwin. Speak of the blonde devil. There he is. To secure the ball. I think that's Merriam on the far side. It's out of bounds. It's going to be a purple ball. It's going to get bias, maybe. Maybe not. Dominic, he's in the box, chips it up. There's Jason Baldwin to punch it away. Purple's going to maintain possession. Wide left. Of course, no one can forget the championship game last year when Jason Baldwin had what can only be described as a heroic save against Skyline High School.
Marlowe
kicks it out. It's going to be a white ball. Marlowe smacked it against the shins of a Viking.
It's O'Reilly.
And this is Rory O'Reilly with the throw in. Oh, that's going to be a purple throw in. There's a corner for Puyallup, scoring opportunity. Well, they're going to bring somebody. They're going to get cute here. They're going to play it short, or are they going to go? Yeah, they are. They're going to play it short. But it looks like got sniffed out by Marlito. There's Joey with his foot on the ball. Welcome back, Joey, from a nice spring break. Judkins. All right, number three is Rory. Over to Dominic. Merriam couldn't catch up with that. It's going to be a purple throw. Well, looks like we got a foul over here. Is that what that is? Yeah, it's a foul. Garden variety foul. Low.
It's Akiana.
Akiana. That's Bo with his foot on it. It's going to be a purple. Good throw in. Bellarmine gets their head on it. That's going to leave a mark, part of the game. offsides. Over and back, one of the Vikings. That's going to be an offsides. See if Jason Baldwin, is going to take the kick here. The rain is really coming down straight. There's no wind. It's just a straight wall of rain. It's probably hard to see. The camera doesn't quite read it, but trust me. All right, that's Dominic. Over to Janikiewski. White ball, Rory does the honors. Get that medical tent out of the way. Baldwin getting ready to boot it, telling his people. There he goes, nice boot. Yeah, all the way to the 40. That's Anthony Daniluk. And that's going to be a white ball. Who is that on the far wing? Is that Marion, I think, with the ball now? Jack Marion. Hard to see from up here. Looking for somebody to break to the ball. Joey is trying to get his attention. Marlowe skims off his head. They're going to let that go out of bounds. It's going to be a goal kick. Get that tent out of my way. That's going to be a white ball. Out. Gonna be a purple ball. Nice. That's Rory. Marlowe there. And Dominic clears it, tries to clear it, but purple comes to it with a one touch. Nice boot. Nice stab at the ball there by Evan. That's wide right. Just a couple of scoring opportunities, a couple of three scoring opportunities by the Vikings. None of them a serious threat so far, but compare that to Bellarmine hasn't really had a single good scoring opportunity yet. We are playing on half a field, and it's the Vikings half. Let's see if we can change that right now. Is that Zach? Yeah, I see Zach out there. He's got the long sleeves under his jersey. On the far side, number 8, Zach Kahn. There's a good ball, trying to outrun our defense. That never did work last year. Looks like it didn't work this time either. Nice ball, way up in the air. Purple's going to come out of it, though. Advantage. It could have been called, but it's going to be an advantage there. Marlowe maintains possession, doing a tightrope walk on the side there on the baseline. Kicks it out by the dugout there. Bellarmine bench. Crossing it. Beautiful ball. 21 is wing. There's Joey. They're going to kick it out. We're going to have... Oh, no. I guess it went off of Joey. Ricocheted off of Joey, and they call a goal kick there. I thought for sure we'd have a corner out of that. That was a decent possession, but no real... No shot on goal, no... Did not really evolve into a scoring opportunity. Zero to zero. That's Janikowski with his head on it. Oh, got a high kick, foul. I'm not sure what just happened there. Foul, maybe high kick, I don't know. Some kind of boo-boo, some kind of mistake, error, faux pas, something. We're only about 12 minutes into the half, 0-0. Two-on-one over there. Two-on-one. And they're going to call a corner kick there. Two-on-one gets a corner kick out of it. That's second best. First best might have been a good cross. Or getting fouled in the box. That's always handy. But corner's not bad. He's hustling. Going to keep it in. Keep it in for Bellarmine. There's a foul. You can't do that. That's a yellow. That's a yellow. Come on. Spare the yellow, spoil the player. There you go. That's how we do. That will encourage good soccer behavior in the future. You like to see players get physical and play with passion, but you got to draw a line at some point. And now the players know where that line is, thanks to the referee showing good judgment. Here we go. That's Zach. Great ball. Oh. I think Wing might have run into, or no, yeah, this Wing might have run into the goalie, and he's being admonished by the ref, you know, to be more careful. We got to watch out. Protect the goalie. I don't see Judkins out there. I think he was in the lineup. And, he's definitely the high scorer on the Bellarmine team. Maybe he is being held in reserve. Nice. That was good defense there. Well, maybe not. They're going to call a foul. Bring out a yellow? No. It was a play on the ball. No. Ref's going to give him a yellow. That's too bad. Rory O'Reilly. Who's coming in for him? I'm not sure. Number 20.
That's Hunter Marston.
That's Hunter Marston coming in. All right, so let's check out this action down here, because this is where the action is going to be. Here it comes. Ball's in the air. Punched out of there by Baldwin. Nice. Nice control. Here we go. We're launching it. Looking to get past that defense. Joab's got a good defense. I know that. It's going to go out of bounds? Nope. Stays in. Miriam, good shot. Oh, yeah. That was a great ball there. It's going to be a goal. All right, Bellarmine comes up with a really good scoring opportunity there. We'll have to look at the replay to see exactly who took that shot.
Zach.
I think it was Zach Kahn. Zach's overdue. He's overdue for a goal this season. Keep on firing away, Zach.
Evan's going after it. Evan got it.
Evan shielding.
Oh.
It's past him. It's going to be a corner kick. Dominic comes over to help. And they're going to play it cute again. Yeah, they like to play it cute. They never like to, they like to work it in. They don't like to just launch it on these set pieces. That was great. This is some great... defensive work, a lot of good fighting for the ball, all of it legal. It's a contact sport.
It's wet field right now.
And
the field is wet.
The field is wet, so it's extra slippery. With his head on the ball. Time of possession definitely favors the Vikings, but the score is all that matters at this point. It's still 0-0. Here we go. Good defense.
Marlow.
Great. Got in the passing lane to steal that. Here we go. Dominic. Gets his head on it. That's going to go off a purple player, and it's going to be a white throw-in.
Marston kicked it off of purple.
Thanks to the quick thinking of Marston. Vikes are making a sub. This dude coming on for that dude. So thank you, that dude, and good luck, this dude. So is this Hunter Marston doing the honors on the throw-in? Here we go. Who's he got there? Bo goes out of bounds. Can't see what's going on. There we go. And look for that. I knew he was going over there. You could see that guy wide open on the other side. Great cross right before it went out.
Nice.
And there's Baldwin to save the day. Jason Blondwin, Baldwin saves the day again. Right on this very field last season where he had some glorious moments. And I invite you to check out those games on DAVEspn. It's going to be a white ball. Joey. Working in close there. Viking defense is, you're not going to catch them sleeping. That's still in. Nope, that went out. Going to be a white throw. Yep. They want to. He's trying to take the customary 20 yards, but ref tells him to get it back out. Come on, White. Get that under control. Oh, let's go. Come on, Bo. There we go. Chipping it in the air for what reason, I'm not sure. I guess that was the only pass available to him. And Anthony took one for the team there and got fouled. Mom and Dad in the stands, the Viking mom and dad don't like that call. They think it wasn't a foul, but it was. Missed opportunity. Baldwin came out and had an open net. Striker kind of maybe took that shot a little too soon, hard to say.
Looks like Daniluk's limping out.
Yeah, we got Daniluk. Anthony is walked out with a limp. Not sure what happened there, but the ref is checking with him.
Barney looks like he's coming in. Number 12, Mac Barney.
Max?
Mac Barney, 12.
Okay. Mr. Barney is coming in for him. Next man up. So here we go. Back to the action. Baldwin plays it short. We're going to work this through our midfield. No, we're going to launch it down as far as we can. Here we go, take two.
Zach,
come on, Zach.
Barney, Joey.
Joey trying to hammer that ball through some Viking legs. Can't seem to get into a rhythm offensively. Settle down. Settle down, gentlemen. It's going to be a purple throw. That's going to be a white throw.
Hunter Marston
tried to get it to Bo, tried to get cute with a kind of a backwards flip, but right into the chest of a Viking. Is that Marlo? Yeah, that's Marlo. Nice work, Marlo. Good pass. Come on, Zach. Let's go, Zach. There you go. Beautiful. Oh. Got a foul. Yeah. Zach held on to that ball just the right amount of time and then passed it to a teammate, but a Viking clipped him and got called for the foul. All right, over to Jack Merriam, back over to Dominic. Pressure. We got a man on here. And Jason Baldwin is going to launch that. Good. Thank you, Jason. He hit that purple trainer's tent. Courtesy of DAVEspn. Thank you very much for sending a message. Maybe next time it wouldn't kill him to move that maybe 3 yards closer to the stands. All right. That's on sides, but too much mustard on that hot dog, and it falls off the bun.
Let's go all the way to Oregon to get the ball.
Yeah. Should have an extra ball by the net. So often we see keeper's having to. Having to chase after it. Still 0-0. We're 25 minutes into the game, 40 minute half. On paper, Puyallup is the better team. You look at their record, but maybe Bellarmine can sneak up on them here, show some grit, and notch a win right in the Vikings' backyard. Purple throw. Dempsey likes to play a formation with three defenders back. It takes some getting used to by some defenders who are used to playing with four in the back. That's a baseball swing at the ball. It goes into the outfield. Go wing. Let him too much. But the Viking kind of shanked it a little bit. And then there comes another Viking in to secure the ball.
Nice, Evan.
Evan. Playing good defense. Evan takes a stab at it. Or was that Dom or Evan? I'm not sure, but first rule of defense is to delay the play. Give your people a chance to mark up, set up, adapt, improvise, overcome. That's off the end line, goal kick. Rain has let up. We had a squall, but last 15 minutes or so, it's been there's been no precipitation to interfere with play. That's going to be a white ball. This is Hunter, I believe, throwing the ball in to somebody that we don't know who it is, because that our friend Barney the Tent there, Barney the Purple Tent is in our way. Watch out, ref. Be a purple throw. Mm-hmm. for it in there. Bo. Oh, clearing it. Who is that on the far side?
Mac Barney.
Barney, yeah, okay. Taking his space. Ref, you got in the way, ref. Come on, stop the play. Baldwin, very aggressive, comes out of the net, has great judgment. Shows great judgment about when to attack, when to lay back, when to punch the ball, when to ground it, catch it, and put it on the ground. He's a complete goalie.
Oh, come on.
That was almost a nice little counterpunch there. Puyallup defense is pretty solid. Meanwhile, Bo puts that back into the play for the White. Swing the ball around. Let's swing it around, boys. There you go. Swing it over here to this side. Excellent. Here it comes. Yes, that's still in. As far as we can tell. Bo, yes. Oh, I tried to get that to a streaking Mac over there, but this Puyallup defense. That was a scary possession there. Very scary. It's going to be a goal kick, but it was almost a goal for the Vikes. And a few uncomfortable situations here for the Lions. Of course, longtime viewers of DAVEspn are familiar with the law of averages. If you're playing and that's that half the field and you got lots of shots on goal, chances are one of them's gonna hit the net. That's going to be a corner kick. Let's see, do they get cued over there? Yeah, they always send a second guy over there. They never launch it into the crowd. They always play it short and try to walk it into the box. Bellarmine got wise to that now. They've got number eight. It looks like Zach out there to guard against such a play, and there he is. And there comes the... There's Marlowe. He's going to boot that out. Marlowe clears it. That was very dangerous. Offsides. Well, we got somebody...
Looks like Jaggar warming up.
Got somebody over here that's... lost a shoe or had his cleated maybe. Not sure. All right. Oh, that's a bad pass right into two Vikings. But it looks like Dominic makes up for it. I think that's Dominic made up for it and booted that out of bounds. We've got about 5 minutes left in the half, plus any stoppage time. I don't think there's going to be any stoppage time. Tell you what, this Viking defense Pretty good.
Nice.
You beat the Vikings tonight, and you can definitely brag about it.
Oh, no.
Still in. He led his player a little bit too much and gets poked out. Gonna be a purple throw. That was a dangerous opportunity. Another nice through ball.
Nice, come on. Get it out.
Up the line, it's gonna be a purple ball. Purple throw. Here we go, we got a sub coming in. Not sure who it is. Looks like Marston going out. And Rory coming back in. O'Reilly coming back in. I think he served his time in yellow card jail and he's back and better than ever. Let's go, ref is like blowing the whistle, let's play. I think there's maybe an offside. The flag went up, either a foul or an offsides call. I'm not sure which. But the field judge is going to overrule the side judge for whatever concern he may have had. Up and down, back and forth. There's a foul. You gotta call that. Right to the goalie. Boots it. An average kick, let's say. Not a particularly good kick.
Shield.
That is going to be a goal kick. Got about 4 minutes left in the half now. Excellent.
2 minutes remaining.
I think the ref might have called that.
I think it went out.
Out. Okay, so it looks like Joey coming off. Actually, Joey's going into the training tent. Doesn't have far to go because the training tent's right in our way, real close to the field. So good for Joey. He's going to get some help there. Okay, ball's back in play. Let's. Wish we could see what was going on, but it looks like it's a purple throw in. Nathan came in?
Yeah, Nathan
Goodwin. Okay. I'm going to call that a cross. Let's call that a cross. I don't think that was a shot.
Oh.
go. That's a white ball. Vikings, we had to wait for the Vikings to make a sub. Nice work, Zach. That's a foul. How do you not call that? Wait a minute. I think they're calling offsides. No wonder he was so wide open there. Offsides. It's going to be a purple throw. Can't be much time left in the half. Can't seem to get into a rhythm. There it is, halftime, 0-0. So we'll catch you on kickoff for the second half. All right, 40 minutes for the second half of Bellarmine Lions against the Puyallup Vikings here at Carl Sparks Stadium. I would be remiss if I did not mention Puyallup's heroic goalie, Nate Vitsum, I believe, last year. Spectacular season for him. Legendary PK shootout. Puyallup fans know exactly what I'm talking about. There's the whistle. Nate, wherever you are, I hope you're doing well. He's a friend of DAVEspn, and so is his dear mother and father. All right, this is a very dangerous time of the game. Players have had a pep talk and a drink of water. It's 0-0. Somebody's going to come out of the locker room with a renewed sense of vigor and urgency. Let's see who it is. That was a tap dance to nowhere right there. Going to be a goal kick. Mr. Baldwin will play it short. Unforced error there by Dominic. Let that slide out of bounds. Wake up, Dominic. You gotta play the second half. Launching it in.
Bo. Evan.
Evan, good job.
Marlon.
Are we gonna be able to clear that?
Looks like Jaggar.
Not sure.
Jaggar's in the game.
Yeah, it looks like Jaggar Judkins is in this half. He was absent throughout the first half up top. But it looks like he will play here in the second half. Baldwin there to save the day. How many times game do I say that? Maybe a dozen. Kind of casual there. Bo gets it.
Judkins.
There we go, Judkins. Judkins against the world.
Oh.
Judkins moves down the field with about four guys all around him, four Vikings. Takes a shot, goalie handles it. Good, back it out. Let's play some smart soccer. No need to force the ball into traffic.
Evan's
going to launch it to the goalie. A little too much on that. It's going to go out. Purple ball. That's out, white ball. That Joey, kind of a big touch there, Joey. Now the ball disappears behind the training tent, and it's going to be a white ball. Who's that? Dominic throwing it in?
Yep.
That's not good. Too casual here, boys. And that is going to be a goal kick. Shielded nicely. Plays it short over there. Is that Miriam over there, number 18? I can't tell. Yeah. Slippery ball. Oh, looks like somebody got helped to the ground with a Viking trip. Still 0-0. Dominic. It's going to go out of bounds? No. Zach, going to keep it in. Come on, Zach. Run through that. No idea what just happened.
White ball.
It's going to be a white ball. Bellarmine is subbing. Bo Akiona is going out, and can't tell who's coming in.
Brandon Wing.
Oh, okay. Wing's coming in. So Bo goes out, Wing comes in. So here we go. There's a white throw. Trust me, it's behind the tent. There you go.
Ooh, nice.
Get it under control. Get it down on the ground, boys. Down on the ground. Looks like Joey. Yeah, Joey came to play tonight. There you go. That's a great ball.
Judkins.
Nice. Come on, Judkins. Come on.
Jaggar.
Out of bounds, white ball.
Evan. No, Evan got it. It's Marlon.
Or no, I guess Evan kept it in bounds. Is that what you saw?
Yep.
Vikes showing no high pressure.
Oh.
Zach miscalculates there. Down the line. Right to a Viking's head. And it looks like we got a foul.
Yeah.
Nice work in the box there. Not fouling anybody in the box. Good work. Is that going to go out of bounds?
It's out. White ball.
Going to be a white ball. Nice work. Wait for your people. Or don't. Zach. Zach, Zach, Zach. There we go. Is that Evan?
Yeah.
Okay. Nobody downfield to kick it to, but delay is the name of the game on defense. Looks like a flop. That goes straight up in the air. It's dangerous. Got a funky spin. Great save by Baldwin. Not sure if that was going to go in or not, but Baldwin made sure that it did not. How many defenders does it take to stop this guy here? That's going to be a corner kick. That was one Viking against the entire Bellarmine defense. And he got a corner kick out of it. Not bad. Are they going to get cued again like they always do? Probably. I would bet money on that. Maybe not. He's walking away. He's going to go long with it this time. Yep. Out of bounds. Goal kick. Mishandled.
Oh, shoot.
Offsides. Sure who that is that's injured down there. Somebody's not. Not feeling good. Who is that? Is that...
I think that is number three.
Oh, that's Rory. That's Rory. Okay, sorry. There we go. Got knocked down. Looks like he tweaked his back. It wasn't Evan. It was Rory.
No, Evan kicked it.
Oh, okay. Dominic, they're going out of bounds. Yeah. Purple throw.
Dominic.
Go, Dominic.
Rory.
That's going out of bounds. Gonna be a purple ball. Has blown his whistle, calling a foul on Joey. Here again, you know, Joey's shoulder to shoulder with the guy. I really feel like Joey gets shortchanged on a lot of these 50-50 balls.
Is it because he was running out of bounds?
I'm not sure. No, he's allowed to do that. I think the ref just takes a measure of Joey's size and slants calls against him.
Joey.
There we go. Nice. Oh, this defense is right there where they ought to be when they ought to be there.
Looking for Judkins.
Judkins is on the far sideline. Could be a white throw.
Sub. Bellarmine subs.
Who's coming in? Dominic's going out.
Barney.
And
Barney and...
Barney coming in, and number two?
Number two is Tate Carlson.
Oh, Carlson, yeah. Where's Tate Carlson?
Is two throwing it in?
He got a lot of time on the first few games of the season. Glad to see him back on the field. Way offsides. You could have called that with Braille. That's how obvious it was. I think Baldwin wants to know why that Viking was not 10 yards off. I'm not sure. There's a good ball. Right through the Vikings.
Miriam.
Midfield. Miriam going to make a cut for it. Vikings take it away. And there's Baldwin to the rescue. Zach, come on, Zach.
Tate. Ooh,
Tate.
Judkins.
Nice, getting it back into the into white possession.
Can't see who that
Tate
is.
Carlson.
Hunter Marston. That's Marston's number 20.
Marston is 20. Okay. It's gonna go out of bounds. White ball. We are 15 minutes into a 40-minute half here. Still 0-0. Bellarmine and White.
Ooh, Judkins. Judkins, one-on-one. Shoot, yes!
Yes.
Judkins.
There you go, money. One-on-one, my money is always on Judkins. I'm just going to start calling him money. 1-0. 1-0. Money Judkins puts it in the net. There's a nice beauty shot for you, Judkins. One of many over the years. For all your friends, family, and fans. Tate puts his head on it, gets it right back into white possession. Foul? Sounded like 2 feet hitting the ball at the exact same time. The laws of physics come into play and let the ref call it a foul. He's a lot closer than we are.
Evan,
nice one touch to clear it, but it goes right to the purple. Offsides.
Oh, good.
This ref is Johnny on the spot, isn't he? When it comes to offsides, he's really watching that line. Vikings, they are definitely awake now. If they were asleep before, they are awake now.
Oops.
Oh, out of bounds, unforced error.
intensity increase. There's more energy on the cumulative side of the waking up.
Nope, sorry about that. Lost the kick for a moment. There's Zach. Zach with a great ball.
Oh. Yes, come on. Come on.
Send it.
Shoot. Give it in. Yes. Score.
Beautiful.
I think that was.
That's a goal.
21.
Who got clocked in the.
I think it was 21.
That 21, so that's wing. And then who scored the goal?
I think 21.
The trailing player. No, 21 got. 21 got clocked on the ground, and then somebody got the rebound. Was it 20?
At the 45-yard line.
The guy at the 45, so that would have been, what number is he? Who is that?
20.
Number 20.
Hunter Marston.
Hunter Marston. Hunter Marston, it's your night. Well done. So it's 2-0. Vikings are really in a hole here.
20.
They are in a hole. They're undefeated in league play. Last year's state championship Bellarmine Lion team tied them once and defeated them once by both games by the closest of scores. So this is a perennial powerhouse.
You got
Zach. Judkins.
Oh, right.
Zillion.
Nobody, oh.
Goalie knocks it down, but nobody there. It's going to go out of bounds, and it's going to be a white ball. All right. That's going to be a purple ball. And we got a sub coming in. Number 11 coming in for some other guy.
Looks like Akiano's.
Akiano coming in for Bellarmine.
Joey went out.
Yeah. Akiano came in.
It's Kate. Brandon. Nobody's there.
Oh, we got a foul. What do we got?
Red card against Puyallup.
A red card. That's something you don't hardly ever see, but I got to applaud this ref. He must have seen something. What happened? Did you see? Boy, I'm going to have to look at DAVEspn on the replay. I don't think I've seen a red card come out that quickly, just right straight to a red. I'm not sure what happened. Did he take a swing at somebody? All right. Is there anybody you can ask? Goodness. They're going to have to play a man down now, I think. Those are the rules in high school.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, man down.
They got to play one man down, and I believe that gentleman who got the red will have to explain himself to, I think they notify the principal in high school around here, and mom and dad, and I just hope there's no public spanking penalty, but it's pretty severe. That's going to go out. It's going to be a purple ball. Boy, I'm really curious to know what brought that red so quickly. I didn't see anybody hit the ground. I don't know what that was all about. I'll find out later. It's way too soon for Bellarmine to park the bus here. They got to stay aggressive.
Come on, Jaggar.
There's Judkins.
Oh. Who's that? Wing.
Oh, goalie comes out smartly. Great save by the goalie. It could have been 3-0 at that point. But Puyallup's goalie really saved the day on that one.
to Carlson, Akiana.
Play it back. There we go.
Evan.
Evan's going to clear it. Goes off of a Viking head, but in the wrong direction. Nobody's got clear possession. There we go. Is that Marlowe?
Yeah.
Nice job. Got it off his head down to his foot.
No. Yeah. Ooh, good save.
Pretty good defense by Evan. Oh, there's a foul. You got to call that, ref.
Evan saved it. Nice. Go. Go, Jaggar.
There's Judkins.
Go, Zach.
Playing that to Zach. And we got a white throw in.
Got a sub. Marston out.
Marston out.
Joey in.
Okay, Marston got himself a goal. Not a boy, Marston. What year is Marston? Does it say on the roster?
10. Sophomore.
He's a sophomore. That's going to be a white ball. Well done, Miriam. Could not see the details, but the result you cannot complain about.
Oh, Evan. Zach.
Okay.
Oh, Pereira, Joey.
That's going to be a foul. Foul on Joey. Really? Was it a foul on Joey? I guess so. Looks like that was an admission of guilt there. The little shake, hands and hug. I think that's a mea culpa.
Still 10.
Yeah, they got to play a man down. Two to one, they're going to dig themselves out. 10 men against 11, and they got the header. Good goal by Puyallup. No time to relax. A little bit of a cushion with 2-0, but now you got no real cushion. Anybody's game, really.
Vikings
tied South Kitsap last week. You don't want to come out of here with a tie. Yes, good skills there by Zach to pluck that out of the air, get it down to his feet, get everything under control, get nice controlled possession here, good passing by Bellarmine. There you go, you got a guy wide open on the wing.
Yes!
Oh my God!
Joey Pereira!
Joey Pereira, the hero of the Pasco game. Joey Pasco Killer Pereira. With the goal from how far out? That's a banger in the parlance of our day.
3-1.
3-1. That should...
12, 13 minutes left.
Should buoy this Bellarmine team. Well done, Joey. You had a guy open on the wing, and I questioned you about taking a shot from that distance. Shame on me. I will never question your judgment ever again, Joey, I promise.
Marlowe's great defense. Merriam.
Jack Merriam, good. Oh, you gotta call that!
Yep, he's calling it.
Who was that? It was Bo that got chopped, took a hit for the team. Yeah, that's a yellow. That was a late hit. You could see that all the way up here. Evan will do the honors. So who do we got on the back line? We got 18 is Merriam. Then we got...
3, Riley. Oh, no, 14. 14
is Dominic.
Number 2,
and
Tate
2
Carlson.
Is Tate Carlson. I wonder where Tate... Where Tate's been. Maybe I had to, because I haven't been recording away games, he's been getting some time in away games. Ball's back in play. Yeah, my money's always on Marlowe. Beautiful work here. Look, where's your... Oh. Good defense. Slam dunk. Judkins. Judkins. White's going to maintain possession. Marlowe getting it back to Merriam. Send it, Merriam. There we go. Oh, there it goes out of bounds. I think he was looking for Akiona to chase
left.
After that.
10 minutes in the game.
About 10 minutes left in the game.
Plus any.
20.
Isn't it 80 minutes?
90. Oh no. Yeah, you're right. 80 minutes. That's right. 10 minutes left. Sorry.
Ooh.
My mistake. That's a foul. 3-1. 3-1 Bellarmine over the Vikings. It was 0-0 at halftime.
They get a free kick.
Got a free kick here.
Dangerous. That's how they scored the last goal.
This is how they scored the last goal, but from a lot further out. Beautiful. Marlowe shielding to let that ball come right back into his shooting right foot. Make that pass up field. But the Vikings take it away.
Oh, nice.
Zach.
No. No. Too high.
That was a great
high.
Shot. And we had a great angle on it here on DAVEspn. I don't think I was in tight enough. But you got the idea.
Somebody's running to get the ball.
Beautiful. Got it out of the air. Onto his foot. But they take it away from Wing. There's Wing. Where are you going with it, Wing? Swing it. Oh. Those Vikings, they are right there. They're really coming after it now. They're all lathered up. They're behind 3-1. Only about 8 minutes left in the match. They are coming after it.
They're down one man.
They're down one man. Red card came out. Inexplicably.
Nice, Zach.
Beautiful. Zach,
Andrew.
Yes.
Go.
That was sweet, Zach, the way you played that to yourself. Oh, that's going to go out of bounds.
Wet grass.
Tate.
Wet turf.
Could not get that under control. It's going to be a purple ball. They're getting it in quick. That's going to be a goal kick.
Okay.
Jason Blondwin is going to send it. Send it deep.
Look for Jagger.
Let's see who is going to come up with it. Wide right. Whoa. That was a missed opportunity for Puyallup. Well, we saw a lot of those by Bellarmine against South Kitsap in the last match. Bellarmine had a lot of goals. Just barely miss. Oh my gosh, Joey, look at that.
Jagger.
Hard ball to handle, Jagger gets it out of the air.
Passing it to
beautiful.
From that,
Judkins over to
Bo. Is that Bo?
Bo, yeah, Bo. They're going to take it away. We're going to maintain possession. Back over to Zach.
Come on, Wayne.
There it is. Wayne, get there. Nice. Cross it now. Cross it.
Oh.
They're going to clear it. Here comes the counterpunch. Stays in. They're going to call a penalty there.
It's against Puyallup.
That's got to be a yellow. Yep.
And, Dominic took a hit.
Dominic is down.
Puyallup got a yellow.
Puyallup, it's a contact sport, and they are definitely playing it that way. Dominic took a whack. We're going to save some battery here and give Dominic his privacy. Come back later. Coaches are coming out. Trainers coming out. All right. We're
taking
back.
Taking out Dominic.
Dominic walking off of his own accord. We're glad to see that he is apparently going to be okay.
Somebody came in. I can't see.
I'm not sure who came in.
Number three, Orion?
For him. Rory was already in, I thought. Maybe not.
Evan kicked it.
How much time is left?
About 3.5 minutes, but then you got to add.
You got stoppage time. 3.5 minutes, but you do have some stoppage time. It's going to be a white throw in.
Joey
kicks it out. It's going to be a purple ball. Evan clears it.
12. Mac Barney.
Come on, Mac. There you go, Mac.
Jagger.
Judkins. It's going to be a white throw. Zach, oh, lazy pass that back. And the Vikings kick it downfield. The defense is there to kick it out of bounds. Who was that? Was that?
That was, I think, O'Reilly.
O'Reilly, good.
Judkins. Come on, Joey. Ah, come on.
Yeah, they're going to call a little touch foul on, it was either Tate or Evan, I'm not sure who.
Time kept on the field.
Time is being kept on the field.
Come on. Oh, come on.
That's out of bounds. Off the end line.
They kicked it.
Header.
They kicked it fast. Bellarmine
went,
wasn't even
wide left.
They rushed it. Bellarmine wasn't ready. Bellarmine got lucky.
They're calling a foul. Calling a foul on somebody on that 50-50 ball.
On Judkins.
Maybe Judkins low bridged a guy or something. I'm not sure. There's the ball. Trying to fall down, maybe get the benefit of a foul in the box, I'm not sure, but whatever he was selling. The ref is not buying. We're down to about a minute and a half. 3-1, Bellarmine. Vikings get a foot on it. There's Zach. Come on, Zach.
Come on, Brandon.
Good. Wing.
Good.
To Joey. Shoot. Oh, Joey slips on the slippery turf. It's going to go right to the white, though. And they're going to take it away.
Oh. It's very wet out there.
There's a foul. Yeah, that's a foul. That's a yellow card.
Another yellow. Marlowe took a hit.
Marlowe goes down, takes a hit for the team. That ref is not going to take any back sass. Puyallup is undefeated in league play, and they are not going down quietly. And I mean that in the literal sense. There's some chatter going on out there.
Oh, somebody red. No, never mind. It's a hand.
I think the ref is saying how much time he's got left. I think he was signifying maybe 2 minutes or something, two additional minutes.
Another foul.
That's going to be a foul on the white.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Nice, Marlowe.
Marlowe. That's going to go out of bounds. Purple ball. We are definitely parking the bus at this point. We are parking the bus in front of the net. Keeper's there. Going to wait until he has to pick it up. Can't be a lot of time left on the clock. Zach, beautiful ball.
Over to Mac Barney.
Mac, good job. Out of bounds, white ball.
Miriam's gonna throw it in.
We gotta have no more than 15 or 20 seconds left at this point. Somebody on the ground begging for a foul call. He's still sitting on the ground. Maybe he's injured, I don't know. That's going out of bounds. Gonna be a white throw.
Joey,
along the baseline. Beautiful tightrope work there by Joey on the baseline, and he slides it all the way down.
And Joey gets back.
Joey, is that Joey?
Yep.
Yeah, Joey. A return to glory here in the second half by Bellarmine. And they're doing this without Dane Price on the field, their star midfielder.
Nice. Oh, great.
Here we go.
Kate Carlson, Marlowe. Oh, Jaggar.
Judkins, he's going to get there. He's going to get there. He's going to keep that in bounds. That's going to be a corner kick.
Corner kick.
As tempting as this might be to bring people up, I would recommend not. You got to keep everybody back to guard against a sudden counterpunch, and who knows what could happen. So I think, yep, that's what they're going to do. We're going to play patty cake in the corner. Keep everybody downfield. Can't be a lot of time left here.
That's Wayne.
That's wing to Zach. It's a foul? They called a foul there?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, that's a foul on Tate.
Good. Come on, Joey. Nice.
Beautiful, Joey.
Come on, Jaggar, you got this.
Judkins.
Go, 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 go. Come on, Jaggar, you got this. Oh.
Goalie comes out, saves the day, Judkins. Had him one-on-one. Can't be a lot of time left, but the ref sure is. And just as I say that, there's the whistle. And your final score just got erased. I guess the goalkeeper.
It was 3-1.
The goalkeeper here at the Puyallup Viking Stadium wanted to erase that as quickly as possible, but... we all know what the score was.
Bellarmine moves into fourth place with 19 points. Curtis and Sumner tied up to drop points. Curtis with 26, Sumner with 24. And Puyallup still sits at the top of the table with 20.
Excellent work tonight. A tale of two halves. They rope-a-dope in the first half, really kept the Vikings in check. 0-0 at the half. 3-1 final score. Beautiful second half. A lot more control. A lot of these guys know each other from club soccer, Puyallup, and Tacoma, right next door. So we will catch you next week. I'm not sure when the next game, home game is, but that's when DAVEspn will be on location. All right then. Three to one. Well done, Bellarmine.